A middle ear infection, or otitis media, is one of the most common bacterial infections during childhood, and sometimes a simple surgical procedure called ear tubes can clear it up. The middle ear is separated from the outer ear by the eardrum and is connected to the upper throat and the back of the nose via the eustachian tubes. The eustachian tubes help equalize air pressure in the middle ear, which can sometimes be lower than the air pressure outside the ear. Whenever you pop your ears by yawning or swallowing, the tubes open up and relieve the pressure. In the same way, the eustachian tubes also help keep fluid from building up behind the eardrums. But if your child gets an upper respiratory illness, such as a cold or sinus infection, the eustachian tubes can get swollen and have trouble working. Fluid can start to build up and put pressure on the eardrum, causing pain or even a decrease in hearing. This fluid can be infected by bacteria living in your child's nasal drainage. This is called an ear infection. An ear infection can lead to a fever, decreased appetite, pain, or irritability. Your child's ear may clear up on its own or could clear up with the help of antibiotics. But if the infection doesn't respond to antibiotics, or if your child has repeated infections, we offer a simple procedure called ear tubes at Children's Hospital Colorado. Ear tubes are tiny tubes that are put in the eardrum, which allow air pressure to equalize. They are also known as tympanostomy tubes, ear ventilating tubes, or pressure equalizing, or PE, tubes. The surgery happens in an operating room. First, your child will be given general anesthesia, a medication that makes your child sleep, keeping them from remembering or feeling any pain during the operation. After your child has fallen asleep, the surgery begins, and the surgeon looks into your child's ear using a microscope. Next, a tiny cut is made in the eardrum, allowing it to drain, and the extra fluid is cleaned up. Finally, an ear tube is placed in the opening. The whole procedure usually takes less than 10 minutes. The ear tubes will stay in your child's ear for 6 to 12 months, decreasing pain, pressure, and improving hearing. Eventually, the tubes get pushed out. They may be covered in earwax, so you may not even notice them. Most children are back to normal a few hours after surgery and may not experience much pain. They may have a mild fever, complain that sounds are louder, or may not feel like eating much, which is normal. You may also notice some ear drainage, which can happen for 2 to 3 days after surgery. Your surgeon may give you antibiotic ear drops until the drainage stops. At Children's Hospital Colorado, we will see your child for a post-op visit 2 to 4 weeks after surgery, and will continue to monitor your child's progress over several visits, which may include a hearing test. The ear tubes should decrease the frequency of your child's ear infections. However, it's still possible to get a new ear infection while the tubes are in place. To learn more, visit our website below.